welcome to the AYTM.com Crosstabs tutorial video. In this video, I will show you how to get more out of the data collected on AYTM. You will learn how to explore statistically relevant correlations between respondents' demographics and survey answers, as well as between answers on different questions of the survey. In no time, you'll be crunching numbers and finding valuable hidden treasures without waiting for a statistician to do it for you. Crosstabs, or cross-tabulation reports, are a very powerful and popular statistical tool. So popular, in fact, that different methodologies are often called crosstabs. To avoid ambiguity, we use the chi-squared test to determine if a particular intersection of data has a high enough correlation worthy of your attention. Why is this important? You can spend hours applying different filters to a dataset, slicing and dicing it into different segments, but still have very little understanding of the overall picture and underlying dependencies between the answers, and the demographic data points accompanying the answers. Crosstab analysis gives you a quick and accurate look into what matters, helping you to dig deeper into promising areas, check hypotheses, and discover unexpected insights. For example, we ran a survey for the Super Bowl in 2014. If you recall, the Denver Broncos are playing the Seattle Seahawks. If you look at the stats page, you'll quickly see that out of 3,500 total respondents, 40.7% were rooting for the Seahawks, 36.2% for the Broncos, and the rest had no favorite team. Since we had gender quotas applied when we fielded the study, the gender split is almost even. When you separate fans by gender, you'll see a clear breakout along gender lines without a clear understanding of whether or not the slight differences in fandom are flukes or statistically significant facts. Crosstabs can help you immediately answer this question with confidence. Here's a crosstab report I pulled from the survey with gender as a banner. As you can see, the females column is highlighted in blue at the intersection with the Broncos and in green for the Seahawks, while male respondents have reversed highlights. This tells us that females were significantly likelier to root for Seattle and males for Denver. We can also tell that guys were less likely to feel neutral about the teams compared to women. Next to this, I have a banner based on the first question of the survey. It tests whether or not fans of those two teams had other differences, exposed by their choices on other questions. As it turns out, Broncos fans were more likely to have watched anywhere from 11 to 48 Super Bowl games in their lives, while Seahawks fans were more likely to have watched only 20 or fewer games. Let me show you how to generate such a report, then I'll give you more details about color coding and how to interpret it. To start, open a stats page of a survey that's either running or completed on AYTM and locate the Statistical Analysis tab in the sidebar. Depending on your payment plan, crosstabs may be either included or available for purchase. Next, make sure that crosstabs is selected from the combo box at the top of the sidebar. If you're interested in the stat sig test, please watch the corresponding tutorial video. One of the few choices you need to make to get the report is your banner selection. A banner is any trait or question from the survey that you want to test for correlations. It's called a banner because in the report, it will look like a large banner across the top as a group of columns with a joint header. The age banner will look at whether people of different age groups are gravitating to different answers. The gender banner will show differences in men's preferences versus women's preferences, and so on. If you keep scrolling below the list of traits, you'll see all applicable questions from your survey that can be used as banners. Some questions have too many choices or no numeric values at all, like open-ended questions, and wouldn't be useful for this methodology, so we'll hide them from the list. Adding a question as a banner will split respondents into groups or columns of people who gave different answers to that question, and the test will check if that answer correlates with any other choices they made in the survey. You can select as many banners as you want. If you have a large data set and a lot of questions, it might make it slightly longer for you to get the report from our servers, and it might be more overwhelming to make sense of the file, but you have final say over the data you select for export. Please note that banners based on survey questions will have top 1 and top 2 links. You can click them to select the top and bottom boxes, or top 2 and bottom 2 boxes. It makes sense to apply those settings only to the questions that have a Likert scale or other regular progression of answers. For example, we asked for level of importance to respondents on a series of things related to the Super Bowl, such as commercials, game outcome, game quality, and so forth. Each item was rated on a 5-point scale: unimportant, of little importance, moderately important, or very important. By default, these will create 5 columns in the crosstab test. Sometimes you won't see any interesting findings, simply because the number of people in each column is too small. Researchers often like to group people together by their overall closeness to one or another side of the scale. If you apply the top two box setting here, respondents who have selected very important and important will be combined in one column and compared to the bottom two boxes, those who have selected unimportant or of little importance. Responses from the middle will be left out. The larger number of responses in these grouped columns may show something interesting. Next, select your preferred confidence level. Move down to 80% to see more highlights, or restrict your data by moving your confidence level to 99% if you want to see only the most reliable findings highlighted. If you're not sure which confidence level to choose, we recommend leaving it at the industry standard of 95%. The slider below allows you to restrict group size for highlighting. For example, you might not want too small a subset of respondents to be considered in the test. Leave this setting at any if you're unsure about the selection that may be best for you. Finally, check the Hide Insignificant Cells checkbox if you want to see only intersections with questions that produced some interesting highlights. All other questions will be omitted from the output to produce a visually cleaner, more relevant report. Now let's click the magical Run Crosstab Report button and wait a few seconds while AYTM servers do the heavy lifting for you. And here's our report. As I've showed you before, we color code statistically significant cells according to the legend in the top left corner. If a banner or intersection made no difference in answer choices on a given question, the cells will remain white. If respondents in a column were more likely to select something, they will be highlighted in green. If they were less likely to select something, they will be highlighted in blue. The shades of the colors are illustrating the power of the association. It's a combination of the strength of statistical correlation and number of people in a column. The greater the power is, the more vivid the color will be. The most vivid colors are for the top 20%, the medium hues are for the middle 40%, and the lightest colors are for the bottom 40%. You can clearly see selected banners across the top. Each will have a sticky header so that it's always in view as you scroll down the table. Banners will have two or more subsets, depending on the number of answer choices or trait ranges within them. Each subset will then have a column for quantity and another column right next to it for percents, so that you can quickly assess the practical importance of each highlight for your study. Percents will add up vertically. I recommend verifying your hypotheses first by scrolling through the report for the most vivid, saturated highlights before looking for everything else. Once a strong correlation is found, the next step is to get an understanding of why it exists. AYTM's unique tools like Personality Radar can potentially answer this and other questions, unveiling the common personas behind the numbers, but that's a whole other tutorial video. Last but not least, if you ran a survey with monadic design, where each respondent was exposed to only one stimulus out of two or more potential stimuli, try using custom banners in your Crosstab report based on the different options you presented to respondents. For example, you can create columns split into viewed or not viewed for each stimulus if you want to see whether exposure to a stimulus had an effect on purchase intent or brand recall. Alternatively, you may want to compare how exposure to different stimuli you tested correlate to particular answers. In this case, select all stimuli as columns and set them all into the viewed position. It's all easier than it sounds. If you don't believe me, download a demo file to play with in Crosstabs and check out the AYTM difference firsthand. That's it for now. Thanks again for watching, and feel free to ping us with questions or to set up a personal demo.